Welcome back for another example of factoring a binomial when we have a difference of squares. I thought we should take a look at this example here that can sometimes cause some problems. This video does assume that you're already familiar with how to factor a basic difference of squares, where if we have a squared minus b squared, meaning we have a difference, the first term and the second term are both perfect squares, which then factors into a factor of a plus b and a factor of a minus b. 49 minus x squared sometimes causes some problems because we're so used to having the variable term first. So there's a couple ways of approaching this. We can leave this in its current form and recognize that 49 is a perfect square, x squared is a perfect square, and we have a difference. So this factors into two binomial factors. The terms in the first position will be the two equal factors of 49. And since 7 times 7 is equal to 49, we have a 7 here and a 7 here. The two equal factors of x squared are x and x. And one's a sum and one's a difference. So this is one correct way to factor 49 minus x squared. But sometimes you will find this factored in a slightly different way. Since we're so used to having the variable terms first, we could rewrite 49 minus x squared as negative x squared plus 49. Notice how the x squared is still negative, the 49 is still positive. And then from here, we could factor out a negative, or if you want a negative 1, if we factor out a negative, it's just going to change the sign of these two terms. So we'd have a negative, or the opposite of, the quantity positive x squared minus 49. And notice how our binomial factor now it does fit the form that we're used to factoring, where the variable term is first, followed by the constant. And again, this is a difference of squares, so we'd have the opposite of two binomial factors. The two equal factors of x squared are x and x. The two equal factors of 49 are 7 and 7. And again, one's a sum and one's a difference. So here's another way to completely factor 49 minus x squared. Even though these two factored forms do look different, they are equivalent and they are also both correct. Of course, if we wanted to verify this, we could multiply these out to make sure that we do get 49 minus x squared in both cases. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful.